wish you a blessed and joyous Easter, even in these trying circumstances. We know that the Lord's love and his light and his hope and strength is with us to guide us in every moment of this life, to lead us always to his peace and his contentment, his shelter and refuge and strength, to be with us in all our human situations. As we celebrate Easter, the resurrection of Christ, I pray that his hope and his strength and his love will be among your family and friends, and all of us, our parish family of Divine Savior, that our faith community may grow ever stronger and be rooted more deeply in the love and the life and the goodness of Christ, and in the life we give each other every day. We're going to begin today by recalling the words of the blessing of the candle. The great light of Christ that is with us in all our human moments, our joys and our struggles, to bring us always his protection and strength and a reminder that we are never alone. Christ our light, Christ our hope, Christ our strength, will lead us to his glory, his salvation, and his love forever. Before the blessing, I want to extend my personal invitation to you to know how deeply our staff and myself are with you at this time. We want to extend to you our best wishes for a joyous and blessed Easter celebration among your family and the treasure of all you love, that you might be lifted up to new strength, to God's goodness, to his peace, and to his love, as you celebrate Christ among us forever, bringing us always the light of his glory and his love. Christ yesterday and today, the beginning and the end, the Alpha and the Omega. All time belongs to him and all the ages. To him be glory and power through every age, forever and then. By his glorious and holy wounds, may Christ the Lord guard us and protect us. Amen. May the light of Christ rising in glory dispel the darkness of our hearts and minds. And may he be with us forever, especially at this time, to bring us his protection, his saving grace, and his healing love. The light of Christ with us forever in everlasting glory.
Death is no more, and Christ lives forever. O Christ, our radiant light shining in our darkness, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
O Christ, the victorious servant who revives life, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
O Christ, the anointed one who brings joy in God, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy, loving Father, forgive our sins and bring us to your everlasting life.
Amen.
Praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him, all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad.
letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, if then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, your life, appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we do not know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed, for they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
On this most unusual Easter celebration, at a time our world has never seen, we're reminded of some things. We're reminded in the important and seminal moments of our lives, we kind of have to be there to really understand them. Isn't that what we say to people when something tremendous or something awful has happened? You have to be there, we say. When we've encountered a moving experience and it's left us a great impression on us, when we try to describe it to those who weren't present, something's lacking. You had to be there, we say. We weren't there on that first morning. We were eyewitnesses to that empty tomb early in that day. But we approach our Easter celebration, especially all the more so this year, with that same incredulous hope of those who were the first to arrive at the tomb. But our Easter Sunday celebration, Christ's victory over darkness and death, and our present moment doesn't seem like much of a celebration, does it? It doesn't seem like a victory for our world. It's battling out this mysterious and frightening phenomenon that reminds us that we're not always able to be in control over the events of our lives. And here is why this day is different than all the others, my friends. In the ritual of the Jewish Seder, on the night of Passover, when all their families gather, it's the tradition that the youngest person who's present, the youngest child, will always ask the same rhetorical question. Why is this night different from all the other nights? These words are echoed in the Great Exultet, the glorious Easter Vigil proclamation, the very same meaning and impact of words. This is the night when Jesus Christ broke the chains of death and rose triumphant from the grave. This is the night when the pillars of fire destroyed the darkness of sin, when Christians everywhere washed clean of sin are restored to grace and grow together in holiness. My friends, today, tonight, and all the others that follow are not about human, but they're about divine intervention for our world, for each one of us personally. God's capacity to love and to forgive is so immense that he sends his very own Son to intervene in our individual and our collective lives, to unleash his plan to rescue us, to save us. We don't feel rescued or saved at the present moment. We certainly don't feel resurrected. It feels like a long and continuing Good Friday over our world and its peoples. And I want to tell you that today, you're not alone if you believe deeply in your heart in resurrection after death, but can't seem to understand it or comprehend it in our present situation. Our story reveals many of the same human emotions and the same kind of responses to this mystery by those first witnesses: confusion, fear, sadness, all words to describe also our collective world's hearts and emotions now. But their sadness eventually gave way to awe and belief because the evidence was mounting. First the empty tomb, then the appearances by the luminous Christ to his companions and his loved ones and his friends, even showing them the wounds, his wounds, evidence of his dying and his rising. And the stories that follow today, all through this season, making this reality clearer, giving them and all of us a reason to believe. Isn't that what our world really needs now? Reasons to believe, stories of resurrection found among us even in this present moment. We have them every day among the tragic and the shadows of this present moment that surrounds us. Slivers of love and goodness breaking through all the despair that we've encountered and witnessed. People delivering food to the homebound. Neighbors standing on balconies cheering on first responders. Parents, patients once stricken, walking out of hospitals amidst victorious cheers of adulation, the human community drawing closer, and global communion in the connected power of the risen Christ, whose love and light overcomes any and all human darkness. For humanity's dark pall of sin and struggle and even death itself is no match for divine strength, divine goodness, and divine love. Because of Christ, death is never its own end. Yes, there is grief and sadness when we lose a loved one, but we can be certain of our belief that we reinforce today that there's always something better waiting for those taken from us, because death is not the end. It's always the preface to something better, something more wonderful, something fuller. My friends, today and every day, especially in this time that presses us more deeply, the living presence of the risen Christ is with us, found in our stories and our lives, found in each other, in our families and friends, in our light and darkness, in the fullness of our humanity when we're not afraid to risk for others, and to do what we can to lift their burdens, ease their struggles, to be there for them in their moments of difficulty, on the times they need us most, in the world shadows also that emphasize the divine light that surrounds us. Why is this? For the glory of humankind is, and the glory of God is fully alive in humankind. Because of Jesus Christ, the morning star who came back from the dead and shed his peaceful light on all humankind, who lives and reigns forever. Things that we do at the Easter celebration masses is to renew our promises to the Lord that were made for us so long ago when someone held us in their arms and promised that we would be connected in the risen Christ and God's life and love our entire lives. So today we're going to renew our baptismal promises in the holy water that will sprinkle us, will remind us of the life and love and refreshment and strength that the Lord gives us whenever we are gathered in the light and hope of the risen Christ. In our Redeemer's victory, we the baptized are buried and raised in newness of life with him. We reaffirm our baptismal promises, reject sin, and renew our commitment to God and his church. And so I ask all of you, do you renounce Satan?
I do.
And all his works?
I do.
And all his empty show?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of our bodies, and life everlasting?
I do.
May Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace, in Christ Jesus our Lord, for eternal life. Amen.
Amen.
Responses, you are the risen Christ, our life. You sanctify us forever as your living body.
You are the risen Christ, our life.
You call us to follow you in victory to eternal life.
You are the risen Christ, our life.
You pour your spirit into our new members.
You are the risen Christ, our life.
You fill our nations with your peaceful presence.
You are the risen Christ, our life.
You grant our sick patient endurance in your grace and mystery. Embrace in compassion and care those stricken with the COVID virus, especially Mickey Marjaluski.
You are the risen Christ, our life.
You carry our loved ones to your glorious home in endless light, remembering Louise Gerkless and this day's intentions, Joseph and Josephine Darris, Jackie Leland, Richard Hornick, Anne and Luke O'Donnell, Joseph, Helen, and Philip Iwan, John Hussey, Ross and Mary Cerniglia, John Braden, Betty Glomsky, Leonard Stancy, Alexander Roble, Jerome Roble, Beverly Roble, and Jenny Chung Lee Yu.
You are
the risen Christ, our life. O God of eternal light, the whole world is now raised up, and all things are restored to integrity in Christ, for he lives and reigns forever and forever.
Amen. Amen.
Dying, he has destroyed our death, and by his rising, he has restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as we joyfully acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. from your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit. You give life to all things, and you make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a perfect sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by that same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he shared this chalice with his disciples, and he said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church, recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son may be filled with this Holy Spirit, become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, and your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and all the saints, and this constant intercession in your presence, we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our communion and reconciliation, we pray, Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, your servant, Pope Francis, and our Bishop Blaise, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you, and your compassionate and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you with their passing from this life, give them kind admittance to your kingdom. For there we hope to share forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and forever. Day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver and save us, Lord, and grant peace to our days. In your great mercy, keep us safe from sin and from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, for the living reign forever and forever.
Amen. Amen.
Peace of the risen Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Share the peace of Christ as sisters and brothers. Christ is always with us to bring us always his victorious strength, his healing grace, his saving love. Now let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by these paschal mysteries, we may all come to the glory of the resurrection forever in Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.